Creating a photo slideshow in trakAxPC is a simple process using our new Photo Slideshow tool. You can access the Photo Slideshow feature in two ways. Firstly, in the media browser, find a folder with photos you would like to use. Right-click on it and select Create Slideshow. The slideshow window will appear, displaying all the images in that folder. This window can be resized to suit your needs. Another way to access the Photo Slideshow tool is through the Media Manager window. When a Media Manager window is open and a folder you are working in contains photos, the Create Slideshow icon will become active. Once you click on this icon, all the photos in this folder will be placed into a slideshow window, ready to be used. To learn more about the Media Manager window, please view the Media Browser New Features video. So now I will go back and open up a new photo slideshow window and demonstrate some of the new features available. When you open up a new slideshow with images, the application will proceed with a quick parsing operation in order for all the thumbnails to be processed in an efficient manner. You can see the progress of this parsing in the top right-hand corner of the window. Beside this, we can see the number of photos that are contained in this slideshow. The thumbnail slider allows you to adjust the size of the images so you can view the files quickly and easily. To preview the slideshow in its current state, simply press the play button. You'll see the slideshow playing in the video output screen. I can use the seek bar to quickly move to any point within the slideshow. You can also start the preview at any image of your choice. When previewing, the image which is currently playing in the video output screen will be highlighted with an orange square. While my slideshow is still previewing, I would like to draw your attention to the segment length and crossfade length sliders. The segment length slider will determine the length of each image within the slideshow. As I move the slider left, I am decreasing the time the photo will play for. And as I move the slider right, the time will increase. The box beside the slider indicates the length of time the image will play for in seconds. You are able to input a time of your choice, up to 10 seconds. The crossfade length slider determines the amount of crossfade between each image. As I move the slider to the left, I'm decreasing the amount of crossfade until I reach zero, which means there is no crossfade at all. If I move to the right, I'm increasing the crossfade between each image. Again, you can input your own time. The time clock beside the sliders indicates the overall length of your slideshow mix. You'll notice as I adjust the segment length and crossfade sliders, the time will either increase or decrease depending on the slider positions. This is a nice feature if you're looking to create a slideshow of a certain length, perhaps to match a length of an audio file you want to mix with. Before I demonstrate how to organize my slideshow and add effects and transitions to it, I will send this slideshow to the mixing window to show you how it looks. Click on the Send to Mix button and select New Mix. As you can see, all the images have been placed in the mixing window with the time and crossfades I have set with my sliders. I will now go back to the media browser and open up a new slideshow window. If I'd like to rearrange the order the photos are currently placed in, I can simply select any image and move it with my mouse to the position of my choice. You can also move multiple photos using the Control and Shift buttons on your keyboard. Multiple photos will be highlighted in blue. You can also add more photos to the slideshow by dragging images from the Media Browser or Media Manager window. Do not worry, these images will not be removed from the original folders. You can also drag a whole folder of new images into the slideshow you are working on. Also, sometimes files will not be in their correct orientation. That is, a portrait photo may be in landscape, or vice versa. You can easily rotate this image so that it will always be in the correct orientation by either double-clicking on the image with the right mouse button to access it quickly, or right-clicking on it and selecting Properties. In the Orientation section, select the correct orientation. If there are more photos in the slideshow, you can use the Next and Previous buttons so you do not have to continuously open the Properties window. Now I will move on and show you how to add effects and transitions to your slideshow. In the Photo Effects section, you're able to add effects to all the photos within the slideshow. To add an effect to the slideshow, simply right-click on an empty box and select an effect from the drop-down menu. Here I will select Tinge. If I press play, I can preview the effect. I can also alter the parameters of an effect by clicking on the Effect Parameters icon in the Effects box. The Parameters window for this effect will open. Depending on the effect, I can choose different options and adjust the level of the effect. I would like to draw your attention to the effects envelope. By inserting effect nodes, you can adjust and control the level of the effect within the mix. To insert a node, double-click on the envelope. Click and hold on the node to move and adjust the envelope. You may wish to have two or more nodes at the same level. Again, hold in the Control key, select the nodes, and choose Level Selected Nodes. You can also control the shape of the envelope between two nodes by right-clicking on the envelope and selecting an option from the drop-down menu. Lastly, you may wish to reset the envelope for a consistent level of effect. Once the envelope has been reset, you can grab it and move it to the desired level. If you've inserted nodes but wish to delete one, right-click on it and select Delete Node. If you'd like to delete multiple nodes, again, hold down the Control key and select the nodes you wish to delete. Right-click on one of them and select Delete Selected Nodes. If you wish to mute the effect, click on the green tick in the Effects box. To turn it back on, simply click again. To remove the effect completely from the box, right-click on it and select Clear This Effect. It will now be removed from the box. You are able to add up to three photo effects onto the images in the slideshow. The Crossfade Effects section only adds effects to the crossfade area between two images. Again, you can adjust the parameters of the effect and control the levels of the effect using the effects envelope. The Transition box allows you to insert a transition between each photo in the slideshow. To change the parameters of the transition, click on the Parameters icon to adjust the properties of the transition. Transitions do not contain an effects envelope. Just to note, if you've selected crossfade effects and also a transition, these effects will work in unison with the transition, as all three are modifying the crossfade area. This provides you with numerous options for creating unique slideshows. If you've created a combination of photo effects, crossfade effects, and a transition that you like, you can save this combination as a preset, so it's available for other slideshows you may wish to create. Click on the Save As Preset button and enter a name for the preset. When happy, click OK to save. Your preset effect will be placed in the custom drop-down menu. Here you will also find some preset effects developed by the trakAx team. Simply click on the custom window and select a preset from the drop-down menu. Finally, I'll send my slideshow to the mixing screen. I can either send my slideshow to a new mix, a mix that I'm currently working on, or any other mix which may be open. Here I will add my slideshow to my current mix. To place it exactly where I want in the mixing screen, grab the play bar in the mixing screen and move it to the area you would like your slideshow mix to drop in. When happy, click on the Send to Mix button and select Current Mix. As you can see, the slideshow has been placed in the mixing screen exactly where I want. I can now add audio and video to complete it if I wish. We hope you enjoyed these new features, and please view our new tutorials to learn more.